Hey guys, welcome to Belly Over Mind with me, Baby Menon. Pineapple Sheera is a luscious and exotic dessert made with sweet and tangy fresh pineapple, roasted semolina which is cooked in clarified butter, that is ghee, and garnished with aromatic saffron and nuts. In northern parts of India, it's called Halwa, while in the western parts of India, it's called Sheera, and in the southern side, it's known as Kesari. Different names, same method, and same taste. This pineapple Sheera is a fancier version of the traditional Sheera. Pineapple is an extra ingredient which is added to the Sheera which makes it exotic. Course, dessert or breakfast. Cuisine, Indian. Preparation time 3 minutes. Cooking time 10 minutes. Total time 13 minutes. Now let's take a quick look at the ingredients as to what goes into making the pineapple Sheera. Half cup clarified butter, that is ghee, 1 cup fine suji, that's semolina, 1 cup fresh pineapple cut into small half inch chunks, 1/2 cup sugar depending on the sweetness of pineapple, 2 cups of water, a few strands of saffron mixed in 2 tablespoons lukewarm milk, nuts, that's cashews and raisins, which is optional. You can also use pineapple essence if you need. Now let us go into the little details of ingredients which, if taken care of, makes the best of Sheeras. First of all, coming to pineapple, use ripe and sweet pineapple for best taste and flavor. I always use freshly cut pineapples for Kesari. If you don't have fresh pineapple, you can make use of the canned ones. I would like to add here that though canned pineapples are super convenient, I would highly recommend using fresh pineapple for this recipe. You can buy the pre-cut pineapple wedges or slices that are available at most of the supermarkets to reduce some of the preparation time it takes with cutting up the whole pineapple. Finely chop the pineapples and add it to the Kesari if you would prefer something to bite on. If you want a really smooth Kesari, you can puree the pineapple and add it. Taste your pineapple first and accordingly adjust the sugar quantity. Mine was really sweet and juicy, so I have used just 1/2 cup of sugar, which gives perfect sweetness. Now coming to semolina, for making halwa or Sheera, make use of fine semolina. But if you have the coarser variety available in your pantry, no worries, use that. Another important aspect is that even if you have the roasted semolina, roasting it in ghee once again adds flavor to the Kesari and makes the semolina granules soft. Now coming to sugar, I have used the regular sugar. You can make use of organic cane sugar also if you wish to have a bit darker colored Kesari. Now clarified butter, that is ghee. If the proportion of ghee and sugar are not proper, the resulting Kesari will turn out to be crumbly and unappealing. The glaze and melt in mouth texture is owing to the right amount of addition of these two ingredients. Do not compromise on the quantity of ghee, that is clarified butter. Now food color. I have not used any food coloring here. I have just added a few saffron strands mixed in a tablespoon of warm milk. Saffron imparts an eye-catching color and flavor when added to the dessert. You can also make use of yellow or orange food color in case you do not have saffron. Now let's get cooking. To make pineapple Sheera, first of all, finely chop the pineapples into small chunks. Heat ghee in a thick pan or kadhai. Add the nuts. Here I have made use of only cashews, fry till golden. Add semolina and roast over low flame till nice aroma of semolina wafts out. Once the semolina is done, switch off the flame and keep it aside. In another pan or kadhai, add a tablespoon of clarified butter, put in the pineapple chunks and sauté for a minute. Pour in water and let the pineapple cook well. Add sugar and let it melt. Now add in the saffron milk. Also add a pinch of salt to balance out the sweetness. Take out from the flame and keep back the pan containing roasted semolina along with the nuts. Pour the pineapple chunks plus water mix into the semolina gradually, keeping the flame on minimum. You got to be very careful as there are chances of splashing and spluttering of the mix. Keep stirring well to ensure that it's free from lumps. Check for sweetness and you can add sugar if you feel it's not sweet enough. Add sugar only after the semolina gets cooked or it will not cook well. Stir and cook till Sheera leaves the sides of the pan. You can also prepare pineapple kesari in pressure cooker. For that, heat ghee in the pressure cooker and fry the nuts. Add semolina and roast well. Now add in the sugar and water. Close the cooker and pressure cook for one whistle. Once the pressure settles, open the cooker and add the pineapple slices or chunks. Cook on low flame for 4 to 5 minutes. Now mix well, remove from flame. Pineapple Sheera stays good for 2 to 3 days in refrigerator. To reheat, you can microwave or gently reheat on stove top with 2 tablespoons of ghee. You can double or half the recipe. Serve this pineapple Sheera warm or chilled as a dessert. You will love this delicious melt-in-mouth Sheera. Each spoonful of pineapple kesari delights you with a tangy bite of pineapple. In addition, crunch of roasted cashews and juicy raisins with the wonderful aroma of clarified butter makes this dish all the more divine. Do try out this recipe and let me know how it turned out for you. Thanks for stopping over and do give the video a big thumbs up if you liked it and subscribe to our channel if you have not yet subscribed. Do not forget to hit the bell icon in order to be notified on the latest video postings. Visit our other social networks, our blog, our Instagram account, our Facebook page, Twitter and Pinterest. The link for the same is given below in the description box. Happy cooking, guys!